Determine f prime of x and f prime of 3 for the given function. We have f of x equals 3x inverse hyperbolic cosine of x divided by 2 minus the square root of the quantity x squared minus 4. Let's first write the given function in the form of 3x inverse hyperbolic cosine of 1/2 x and then minus the quantity x squared minus 4 to the power of 1/2. Remember, we have to convert radicals to rational exponents to determine derivatives. And now to find the derivative, we need to apply the product rule for this first product and then the chain rule for the second part, which indicates f prime of x equals, for this first product, we'll let 3x be the first function, which we'll label f, and the inverse hyperbolic cosine function be equal to g for the second function. And therefore, f prime of x equals 3x times the derivative with respect to x of inverse hyperbolic cosine of 1/2 x plus the second function of inverse hyperbolic cosine of 1/2 x times the derivative of the first function, which is the derivative with respect to x of 3x. And then we have minus the derivative with respect to x of the quantity x squared minus 4 to the power of 1/2. Next, we differentiate here, here, and here, and then simplify. To differentiate inverse hyperbolic cosine of 1/2 x, we apply the derivative formula shown here, but I'm going to apply the derivative formula in the form of 1 divided by the square root of the quantity u squared minus 1 times u prime. So we have 3x times, to differentiate the inverse hyperbolic cosine function, notice u equals 1/2 x, and therefore u prime equals 1/2. The derivative is equal to 1 divided by the square root of the quantity u squared minus 1, where u is 1/2 x. The square of 1/2 x is 1/4 x squared. We have minus 1, and then times u prime, which is 1/2. Plus inverse hyperbolic cosine of 1/2 x times the derivative of 3x, which is 3. Then we have minus, to differentiate the quantity x squared minus 4 to the power of 1/2. U is the base of x squared minus 4, which indicates u prime equals 2x. The derivative is equal to 1/2 times the quantity x squared minus 4 to the power of 1/2 minus 1, which is negative 1/2, times u prime, which is 2x. Now let's begin to simplify. Let's begin by focusing on the square root of the quantity 1/4 x squared minus 1 times 2. Because the square root of 4 is equal to 2, we can move this 2 under the square root and it becomes a factor of 4. So again, 2 times the square root of the quantity 1/4 x squared minus 1 is equal to the square root of 4 times the quantity 1/4 x squared minus 1, which is equal to the square root of x squared minus 4. So let's go ahead and write this first product as 3x divided by the square root of the quantity x squared minus 4, plus 3 inverse hyperbolic cosine of 1/2 x. And then for this last product, 2 divided by 2 simplifies to 1. If you want to use a positive exponent, we can write this as minus x divided by the quantity x squared minus 4 to the power of positive 1/2, which is equivalent to the square root of the quantity x squared minus 4. And now if we look carefully, we can combine these two fractions because they have a common denominator, and we subtract the fractions by subtracting the numerators, and the denominator stays the same, which indicates f prime of x is equal to, subtracting the two fractions, because 3x minus x is 2x, we have 2x divided by the square root of the quantity x squared minus 4, and then plus 3 times inverse hyperbolic cosine of 1/2 x. Now that we have f prime of x, we can determine f prime of 3 by substituting 3 for x. When x is 3, for this first fraction we have 6 divided by the square root of, the square of 3 is 9, 9 minus 4 is 5, giving us a square root of 5, and then plus 3 times inverse hyperbolic cosine of 1 half times 3, or 3 halves. This is the exact derivative function value, and now let's evaluate this on both the T84 as well as the Desmos graphing calculator. Using the T84 first, we enter 6 divided by second x squared for the square root, 5, right arrow, plus 3. For the inverse hyperbolic cosine function, we'll use the catalog by pressing second 0, and then we'll go down to the C's by pressing the green C, which is the program button. And now we scroll down to inverse hyperbolic cosine, which is here. We press enter. 3 divided by 2, close parenthesis, and enter. To 4 decimal places, we have 5.5706. Let's also evaluate this on the Desmos graphing calculator. To do this, we enter 6 divided by the square root of 5, right arrow, plus 3. We can simply type in the inverse hyperbolic cosine function. Right arrow, 3 divided by 2, right arrow, close parenthesis, enter. And we can see we get the same result, approximately 5.5706. I hope you found this helpful.